The Horse Stealer and Other Stories by Anton Chekhov. Narrated by Belinda Hillman. A Slander. Sergei Kapitonich Ivany, the writing master, was marrying his daughter to the teacher of history and geography. The wedding festivities were going off most successfully. In the drawing room, there was singing, playing, and dancing. Waiters hired from the club were flitting distractedly about the rooms, dressed in black swallowtails and dirty white ties. There was a continual hubbub and din of conversation. Sitting side by side on the sofa, the teacher of mathematics, Tavanchilov, the French teacher, Pastakoy, and the junior assessor of taxes, M. Zita, were talking hurriedly and interrupting one another as they described to the guests cases of persons being buried alive and gave their opinions on spiritualism. None of them believed in spiritualism, but all believed that there were many things in this world which would always be beyond the mind of man. In the next room, the literature master, Dodonsky, was explaining to the visitors the cases in which a sentry has the right to fire on passers-by. The subjects, as you perceive, were alarming, but very agreeable. Persons whose social position precluded them from entering were looking in at the windows from the yard. Just at midnight, the master of the house went into the kitchen to see whether everything was ready for supper. The kitchen, from floor to ceiling, was filled with fumes composed of goose, duck, and many other odors. On two tables, the accessories, the drinks, and light refreshments were set out in artistic disorder. The cook, Marfa, a red-faced woman whose figure was like a barrel with a belt around it, was bustling about the tables. "Show me the sturgeon, Marfa," said Ioniv, rubbing his hands and licking his lips. "What a perfume! I could eat up the whole kitchen. Come, show me the sturgeon." Marfa went up to one of the benches and cautiously lifted a piece of greasy newspaper. Under the paper, on an immense dish, there reposed a huge sturgeon, masked in jelly and decorated with capers, olives, and carrots. Ioniv gazed at the sturgeon and gasped. His face beamed, his eyes turned up. He bent down and with his lips emitted the sound of an ungreased wheel. After standing a moment, he snapped his fingers with delight and once more smacked his lips. Aha! The sound of a passionate kiss. "Who is it you're kissing out there, little Marfa?" came a voice from the next room, and in the doorway there appeared the cropped head of the assistant usher, Venkin. "Who is it? Ah, delighted to meet you, Sergei Kapitonich. You're a fine grandfather, I must say, tete-a-tete with the fair sextet." "I am not kissing," said Ivany in confusion. "Who told you so, you fool? I smacked my lips in reference to, as an indication of pleasure at the sight of the fish." "Tell that to the marines," the intrusive face vanished, wearing a broad grin. Ivany flushed. "Hang it," he thought. "The beast will go now and talk scandal. He'll disgrace me to all the town, the brute." Ivany went timidly into the drawing room and looked stealthily around for Vankin. Vankin was standing by the piano and, bending down with a jaunty air, was whispering something to the inspector's sister-in-law, who was laughing. "Talking about me," thought Ivany. "About me, blast him. And she believes it. She laughs. Mercy on us. No, I can't let it pass. I can't. I must do something to prevent his being believed. I'll speak to them all, and he'll be shown for a fool and a gossip." Ivany scratched his head, and still overcome with embarrassment, went up to Pastakoy. "I've just been in the kitchen to see after supper," he said to the Frenchman. "I know you were fond of fish, and I've a sturgeon, my dear fellow, beyond everything. A yard and a half long. And by the way, I was just forgetting, in the kitchen just now, with that sturgeon, quite a little story. I went into the kitchen just now and wanted to look at the supper dishes. I looked at the sturgeon and I smacked my lips with relish at the piquancy of it. And at that very moment, that fool Vankin came in and said, 'Ha, ha, ha, so you're kissing here, kissing Marfa, the cook.' What a thing to imagine, silly fool. The woman is a perfect fright, like all the beasts put together, and he's talking about kissing. Queer fish."
"Who's a queer fish?" asked Tarantulov, coming up. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.